What's up, everybody, and welcome back to 2000 Play Games. We're playing Mafia 2 again, and Stutterfuck Justin is here with us.
Chill with the SF.
Wow, the SF is live today. So, we just stole the fucking hot rod. If you didn't know that, don't be a bitch. Watch part, 10, whatever the fuck this is.
Just watch the whole series.
Yeah, just watch the whole series, you fucking cockhead. Floating on top of a car.
Where you at,
Billy? I'm stuck in the car.
Then get the hell out of
here. I'm literally stuck in the car.
Yo, the graphics, dude, the mechanics.
I am stuck. We're good.
You jumped out.
I just know I moved, like, vertically through the car.
Oh, that's...
Or horizontally through the car.
That's sad. Yeah. And now you're back in it.
Yeah, because I wasn't pulled up on it enough, so I had to get back in and pull it out, and now we're good.
You know, you have the coolest games, bro.
Dude, it's fine.
You really do.
Dude. This game is great. Hey, don't ever say NA on my fucking
video. Yo, guys, it's gotta be a new thing. Everyone say
NA.
Not,
first of all, it's not new.
It's a new thing.
No.
I started it.
No, you didn't. Actually, you didn't start shit.
Yo, alright, so guys, I'm starting this thing where
you're
say
not starting
NA.
It. You're, like, literally, you're just an idiot.
Like, the best fruit cup in NA. Like, I'm the
See,
best.
See, that's first of all not how you said it. Second of all, shut the fuck
it's
up.
The money.
Also,
it's a cutscene.
Oh.
Well, that's a fucking relief. Stupid fucking junkies. Now they know their place. Good
fuck
work,
that
boys.
Slimy ass, rodent man,
thanks,
rat face.
So, you need anything else from us today, or is that it? I got something I gotta take care of. No, that's all. Okay. I'll call you if you need anything.
It's a lot of words for you, I'm proud of you.
It actually was.
Yeah, you don't really know a lot of words.
I do.
No, English is really hard for you.
Yo.
Is this the epitome of a good game?
This is the epitome.
If you don't get the epitome joke, fuck yourself. Watch the goddamn videos, you piece
Here
of
is
shit.
What we have.
Epitome.
Dude, what should I go with? What drink?
The red one.
What?
That one right there.
Coffee?
You know. That one.
Whiskey, brandy.
You see it?
I got brandy.
That's not what you want.
Brandy's nice, dude.
He's drunk now.
He's not
gonna car crash die.
Car crash die? Yeah. See, what I tell you, English is hard.
Kinda
words are hard for you.
It is hard.
Yeah, words are hard for you.
Car crash, and then he dies.
So he's gonna die in a car crash.
No, like he car crashes, like his car crashes, and then he dies.
So he's gonna die in a car crash.
But like, I don't know, like maybe if he gets into a car crash, he falls over, and he like gets up in the middle of the street, and like a cat kills him. I don't know what's gonna happen. I know that he will crash his car. Like, I know for
you
a fact.
Are honestly, hands down,
how can I help?
The dumbest motherfucker I ever met. Hands down. I've met some pretty dumb people.
Yeah.
Top of the list. You're at the top of the list.
I'm the bottom of the list.
Dude, you're the bottom of the barrel.
No.
Top of the list.
I'm the top of the cool kid list.
Like, as far as dumb people go, it's like you, Doornail, and everybody else that I met in my whole life.
That's not true.
Yep.
I'm honestly pretty brilliant.
No. No.
Brilliante.
No problem.
That's not even how you say it in Spanish.
Brilliante!
Literally not how you say it.
Brilliante?
Just because you say it a million times doesn't make it right.
I was saying it in different pronunciation.
Brillante is how you say it.
Brilliante.
Yeah, dude, you got it. Nice. So, English is not only hard for you, Spanish is too.
That's a hard language.
I think existing is just really difficult for you. I think you have like a lot of trouble just existing.
Yo, one of the most annoying things is I get into the most awkward situations at work. Like, they'll say, "All right, Justin, have a good time at break." I'm like, "Thanks, you too," but they're not on break. They're just like chilling at the register.
So you're just a cock.
And then sometimes I'm like, "Hey, what you doing?" And like, "Nothing, I'm just chilling. Like, what about you?" And I'm like, "I'm just, you know, just being me."
That's not an answer. That's not a.
That's a conversation.
That's honestly, you're a really good person to talk to, it sounds like. It sounds like you have a lot of fun over at work.
Oh, they love talking to me.
Yeah, I bet they do.
Especially the old ladies.
Yeah, I don't find that hard to believe. You're just dumb enough for them to think of you as, like, their half-retarded stepkid.
That's not nice.
No, not nice.
Unless you're not person.
Maybe.
High key.
Low key. Like, so low, you haven't even found it yet.
Like, it's beneath the earth.
You're literally just a lot of untapped potential, that's what you are.
I am.
You're potentially smart.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll take that.
Yeah.
I'll take that.
Yeah.
I heard smart and mean in the same sentence, so...
Yeah, that's... See? Example number one. There you go, you're already getting there.
I'm getting there.
Thanks
nice.
A lot.
I just gotta read books.
Did you like that nice new car?
Come on, it's a new car. Do you see it?
Dude, it's dumping your shitty ass SUV.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
If I put like a skull on the side of it, it'd be cool.
No.
It would.
Like, no.
If I painted it white with a black skull on the side, it would be cooler than this fucking piece of shit.
What?
Like, deadass.
Like, first of all, no.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Second of all, you just by saying that said that it is doper than your stupid ass SUV. Because you said that in order for your SUV to be doper than that, you'd have to paint it white and put a skull on it. Which means that my car is currently doper than your SUV in its current condition.
The thing is,
you're an idiot.
I said that because...
And also, if you did put a black skull on your car, I would bully you.
That's why I'm saying it. Because it would look terrible. That's how bad your car is.
I would give you a swirly.
What's a swirly?
Like, I stick your head in the toilet and flush it.
People do that?
Yeah. You want to see?
No.
I'll give you a swirly.
Yo, have any one of you gotten bullied like that before in school? Because if you did, I'm very sorry.
Dude, you're not in school right now.
But I was.
But it's the summer.
But I'm going to be. But when they watch this video, who knows where they are?
Yeah, but like, you're not, you're in college. You don't get bullied in college.
You don't know that.
It's not a thing.
That's not a, I mean, it is actually.
No.
Have you seen people play Yu-Gi-Oh? They get bullied.
Well, if you're playing Yu-Gi-Oh in college, you got some life decisions to reevaluate.
Oh, yeah, and dude, they all just sit.
It's like, not like it's Pokemon Go.
I have a lot to say about that shitty-ass game.
Don't ever say that again.
Shitty-ass game.
See, this is why nobody watches our YouTube channel.
Why?
Because you just suck at life, and you think that fun things are bad and bad things are fun.
All I know is the fun games like Bloodborne and Dark Souls are actually good games.
I'll be right there.
And Pokemon Go is ass. This game is mid.
Just because you suck at a game doesn't make it ass. It may make it not fun. Although, if I suck at a game, it is ass.
Pokemon Go takes no skill to play. There is no skill gap. There's no like skill ceiling for good players. And bad players. Like,
To clarify for everybody, Justin is spouting off these completely foundationless accusations against a brilliant game. And he's over here talking about the skill requirements for the game.
That's
because
right.
He is currently level 6. Is that what level you are?
Oh, yeah, level 6.
Level 6. And I am level 21, almost level 22.
Hey, buddy, you're interfering with
so now, see, if the roles were reversed, we'd be having the opposite argument, because Justin would be better at it.
That's not true.
But Justin's tiny, tiny, minuscule little brain cannot fathom anybody being better at a video game than he. Hence, the fact that he claimed to be top 10 in Overwatch when he is currently sitting at number 1,000.
But even
which
so...
would be impressive... had you not claimed to be 10th in the world. Just so everybody knows where we stand.
But I'm going to be... Okay, guys, just for the information dump here. I have a series with my sister where we talk about Overwatch, and it's like the road to 500th rank.
Yeah, he's currently sitting at a 1,000th.
So I'm very close. If I win six more games, then I'll be 500th rank.
I'd like to introduce you to somebody.
And I will do that because I never lose.
This is Carlo Falcone.
That's not true. He has to throw out so much footage because he already lost. But now shut the fuck up. We got a cutscene.
Okay.
So Vito.
That stinky ass.
How do you feel about Alberto
Rose-headed green goblin-looking ass with the stupid nose and his cigarette?
The way I see it, those assholes tried to steal $5,000 from me and then left me in a rotten jail.
That's good.
Because the two of them are planning to make a move on us. So it looks like we're going to have to do something before they do something. Eddie will tell you the rest.
Nice, dude. I think that's what
I'm sure you won't let me down.
Bye, Mr. Falcone.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
He's pissed. He's like, I'm out of here.
He's a mob boss.
Fuck that Justin guy.
He's a mob boss.
A car with three of our guys in it disappeared last night. And word around town.
Why would you pour that in the middle of the fucking recording?
Guys, this is seltzer water.
Like, are you stupid?
Tony Balls and Frankie
Don't pour anymore.
If he talks,
We're all fucked. I needed the water, bro.
How many times were you thrown on your head as a kid? Follow him to find out if he's involved. You literally did it right next to the mic. Find
out that he no, had I didn't.
To do with yeah, it. Your cup is still right next to the mic. If any of our guys is still alive, try and rescue him. You're over here talking about the skill gap in Pokemon Go. There is an intelligence gap in you and common sense that is unreal. I got no idea.
So how go prepare.
Unfathomably large.
Let's just make an example real quick. Right,
you and existing are like polar opposites. Like you just struggle about this to exist.
My awareness in life is on point. Let's just say today I almost made a pretty dumb remark. But your boy has like 20/80 vision, what do we have? And he saw the people that I was not talking about, but something that they might find offensive. So I was like, oh, never mind, I'll just have something different here.
So, since Justin is full of shit and everybody who watched any video by us ever knows that by now, I will clarify what actually happened. We were at the gym.
Yeah.
And he was talking to me while I was while I was sitting down facing said party that Justin was just about to offend. His back was to them, and he went, "I don't like," and stopped because they walked past him and surprised the shit out of him, and we started laughing. He did not have 20/80 vision.
I had 20/20/20/20 vision.
His 20/80 vision's also very fucking bad.
Is it really though?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Because
I have 20/10 vision.
Okay, here we go.
And that's like top percentage of the like world of the human population is 20/10.
I want that kind of vision.
Well, you don't have it.
I have it
now. Nope. But yeah, so basically what happened was Justin was about to offend two very angry-looking women.
Yeah, angry.
Very angry. They were the type of people that like would actually kick the shit out of you and then like somehow you would feel sorry about it and say, like, apologize to them.
And somehow they'd be the victim.
And, yeah, they'd still be the victim.
Yeah.
But that was basically the type of people that were walking by right as Justin was about to say, "I hate fat girls."
Oh, it would have been so bad.
Now, he was not serious. Nobody get offended. Nobody freak out. It was, like, the trail of a conversation, and he was just being an idiot.
Yeah.
But he was about to say this as two not fat girls but very scary girls were walking by, and he would have offended the shit out of them. And basically,
but
nothing
boy,
but pure chance saved Justin's dignity.
But your boy had a 20/20/10 vision. If he looked to his
that's
right
not a thing.
At eagle eye speed, he was like,
"See, that doesn't make any sense either."
Shit, I can't say that word in front of them.
This is what happened. They were literally in front of you when you like stopped. They were literally like in front of you, like in front of your vision.
I grew eyes in the back of my head.
Well, that could be true, but they wouldn't have helped you because they were standing in front of you.
They weren't.
You could have had 20/80 vision and still seen them. That's how close they were to you. Not to mention they actually startled you because you jumped.
I did not.
You did. You jumped.
Are you sure about
you jumped. I saw it and I laughed.
I didn't jump.
No, you jumped.
You laughed.
Yeah, I laughed because you jumped. And then I realized, because I didn't know what the comment was going to show at this.
And then I told you.
And then you told me the comment after they left and we're out of earshot.
Yeah.
I literally laughed because you jumped. Because you got startled by two seemingly vicious women.
Didn't they look vicious, though?
They could have been very vicious.
I was nervous.
One of them is definitely vicious.
Oh, at least one of them. The other one, I don't know.
Other one, it's like hit or miss.
Yeah,
she probably could rip your face off.
50-50 shot.
It's fine.
I put it safe, though. Your boy knows what he's doing.
Like yeah. Right. So, no, but it's fine. You really didn't play it safe. Gotta get you literally just got, like... Seen. Like, this is the whole dumb luck. Like, you were dumb and got lucky.
I think I'm not dumb. I got a brain that's very big. And, I just got good eyesight.
Nope.
That's so, the bottom line here.
So, this is now where looks it like starts I can pry to get off. Actually, interesting.
Okay.
Breaking into a sewer.
That's not interesting.
It could be.
I mean, it
maybe
just,
somebody
like,
shat out something
Christ
interesting.
Christ,
like a crocodile.
That's true.
Yeah,
that's
so
like a giant rat came flying at you.
Yeah, or like Sammy Davis Jr.
Who's that?
Dude, come on.
Yo, I know who someone is, though.
Yeah, dude, you know who someone is?
Tim?
Shit, that dog could
no.
be a problem.
Clint Eastwood.
Oh my god.
I know who that is.
Dude, nice. I'm happy you don't live under a rock.
I know.
Congratulations for owning a television set.
Yep. Fuck.
I learned that with my own mind.
That just doesn't make sense. That's just like, you do not have innate knowledge of Clint Eastwood's existence.
That is a...
You have no idea what I just said, do you?
I do.
You followed that?
Yeah, a little bit.
Innate is in your vocabulary?
I think so.
Existence is?
That one is.
Of is? I know that's a pretty big word for you.
Maybe not, actually.
Two letters is a little hard for you.
It is.
Everything past one just gets a little... it gets muddled, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, but... what I just said, I learned that with my own mind. That is a reference to Bloodborne, so...
Well, that's even stupider then.
When you meet that man, you're gonna love him.
I won't.
You will actually hate him.
I will hate him. I like Bloodborne all the time, so it doesn't matter.
You're gonna love it. It gets so good.
Probably not.
It gets lit.
Stupidest fucking game ever.
This game is the epitome of stupid.
Shut up before we turn you into meatloaf.
No, this game is dope.
Well,
you get to be a badass-looking mafia member.
Now I got you, you skinny.
He's badass-looking?
Well, right now he's covered in shit, literally.
Yeah, that's what I mean, badass, like, no.
That's not bad.
Is that a dog? Like,
yeah.
Dude, you're dead.
Dude. I'm literally still breathing.
How's that dog not, like, jumping over the fence killing you?
Because it's a tall fence and it's a dog?
He can jump.
Okay.
He can jump.
Yeah, not that high.
He has four legs. He's got some leg power. Just jump over it. I could do it if I was a dog.
You're serious. You're actually serious.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, I used to think that you were just, like, dumb because it was funny. But you're actually serious.
Well, it makes sense because he has four legs.
Yeah, so he could jump twice as high, right?
I mean, that makes logical, yeah, like, because, mathematical sense.
Well, let me see. Carry the one. And, I just keep getting Justin's an idiot. That's my answer.
How do you get that answer from numbers?
Because you do 2, and then you gotta carry the 3, and then you add fuckhead, and then you divide by Justin's brain, and then, so you can't divide by 0, because Justin's brain doesn't exist, so you have to throw in Justin's brain plus stutterfuck, and when you divide that, you get Justin's an idiot.
I don't think that's how...
Yeah, no, you didn't follow that?
Yeah, I lost. I was
Makes
lost.
Makes sense, you're an idiot. You wouldn't be able to.
Well, it's not a math thing. Like, it's not
Dude,
real.
It is, but it's fine. Idiots don't get it. You didn't get that far in math. It's fine, dude.
I'm good at
math.
There's
nothing to be ashamed of.
High-key good at math, though.
Everybody learns at different paces. It's okay you're still in first grade level reading.
I've actually...
There's nothing...
I'm a good
there's
reader
There's nothing
booker.
Wrong with that. Did you say reader booker? That's fine, dude. It's okay. You'll learn that next week. When you learn verbs for the first time.
You know what? I'm going to start reading books to get smart.
Yeah, dude?
I am. And you're going
to
get...
I got a good one for you to read.
Which one?
Cat in the Hat. And then after that, you could read Green Eggs and Ham.
Have you heard of Rick Riordan?
No.
That's pretty good. I recommend Rick Riordan.
Yeah?
He's got books like... Or the series, The Ranger's Apprentice. Or...
Is that
or,
The Sorcerer's Apprentice?
No.
Is that one of them, the Nick Cage movie?
That one was based off The Last Apprentice, and that one sucked.
The movie?
Yeah.
Or the book? The movie was dope.
The book was amazing.
Dude, Nick Cage is God.
No, he's not.
Yeah, but still, if he was, that'd be sick.
The movie sucked.
Hey, dude, you too.
You I like Bloodborne.
I shouldn't... I never
like, you can't
it.
Talk about things sucking. You like Bloodborne.
Bloodborne's one of the best games of all time.
No, it's not.
It is.
It's literally not even one of the best games. Like, if every other game blew up, I still wouldn't want to play Bloodborne.
Dude, the game itself...
I'd rather eat chalk than play Bloodborne.
No, you wouldn't.
Yeah. I'd rather move to North Korea than play Bloodborne.
Have you seen Bloodborne?
Yes.
Have you really seen it?
Yes.
Have you took the time to, like, look around?
Yes.
Get good at the game?
I don't have that kind of time.
No, you don't.
I will die
a
before
lot.
That happens.
No.
Like, figuratively. Like, not figuratively. I will literally
like,
die.
Legit,
I will perish. I will cease to exist.
So, what you're saying is, you're gonna go hollow.
No, what I'm saying is that game fucking sucks.
No, what you're saying is you suck at Bloodborne.
Yes, because the game sucks.
No, it's a fantastic, amazingly amazing
no, like,
game.
See? Right now, if you look at Vito, right?
Sure.
Look at him. You see all that brown stuff on him?
Yeah.
You know what that is?
Probably shit.
No, it's actually Bloodborne. That's what it is, right there.
Very funny.
Bloodborne's all over him. Just smeared on him. It's just Bloodborne everywhere.
Bloodborne is too high of a tier to be on this game's level. Never mind some dumbass coat.
It's literally just smeared all over him. You don't see it?
No.
But you can see Fuck Justin all over him.
Yo, you're in a gunfight.
I'm not in a gunfight.
You're about to be.
Maybe.
Possibly.
Could be.
You're about to be.
You think so? Maybe. Could happen.
Oh shit, we got a movie next scene going on.
A what? It's just a question.
Yo, are they hanging nice by their hands? Fucking kill you first. That's not good.
Dude, nice. You caught up.
What's that fucking like, that's not good at all.
Yeah, that's a bad thing. Right?
Oh. Yeah. Hey, somebody's over there.
Every time you go to drink hey, that fucking cup, I have an overwhelming urge to just slap it out of your hands. Jesus Christ. What is we literally need to get a face cam just so I can beat the shit out of you and like everybody will see it.
I don't want to be hurt.
So, face cam it is.
We will never get a face cam.
I will get it when I go on vacation this week because it's tax free.
Please don't do that. Falcone. Please don't get a face cam.
Yep. No, I'll just hit you. I'll just hit you whenever you're annoying.
I will legit come
like this. Ready?
Ow!
You heard that? That's what you'll see. It's great.
I want to wear a sweatshirt so I can like cushion the blows. But
that don't matter. I'll hit you in the face.
The room got like the hood of a sweatshirt and like the strings that pull the thing over your face. I'll just wear that all the time.
So I'll just go right to the eyes, poking the eyes.
I'll sort of like I'll push it down.
Okay.
So you get me. Yeah. And I'll close my eyes just in case.
I'll just have to buy a knife when I buy the face cam.
Well, you're gonna kill me then. So
no, it's fine. I'll just you can stab somebody like you know 400 times without actually.
That's true.
Yeah, there's like 4 different places you can stab back.
Well, yeah, like the toes, the fingertips.
You want me to cut your fingertips off, dude? That's gross.
Dude,
come on, there's little kids watching this.
No, there's not. There's not one little kid watching this.
There's not one person watching this because we're just recording it right now.
That's true. That's really true.
Do you see me beat this guy up?
No.
Dude, normally you get excited when I hit you.
But like, you're not good at fighting, so it's not the fun to watch.
I am very good.
You're mediocre.
See, you suck at picking out fun games.
It's not true.
So when you see a fun game being played, you're like, wow, that game looks fun, but I can't let him know. So you don't insult the game, you just insult me. But like, you're not good at insulting people either.
Look at the game. Boys.
Take care of it's from 2008. It's pretty good for 2008.
Down.
I don't know if you've ever seen a movie before, but like, that's not
it.
Dude, I thought you knew who Clint Eastwood was. Like a movie. Very cinematic game, yes.
That's not what a game should be like.
Why?
Because. That's not how it works. A game is a game you experience through mechanics and learning the game, not...
You love the word mechanics.
Actually,
you say mechanics 8,000 times.
It's a great word.
Like, you can... You realize that they're... Like, I just did a playthrough of the main storyline. Like, you can play this game for hours while, like, not running out of things to do. You know that, right?
That's because the game sucks.
That's because it's non-linear.
There's a bunch of, like, random missions.
It's relatively... No, that's not how this game works either. Stay you always here. Have one checkpoint.
Don't come out until we come get you.
No, it's a linear story.
Bullshit missions.
You don't have bullshit side missions.
Hostage situations.
There's no hostage situations.
You got to follow people around.
That's, like, only part of an actual, like, mainline mission.
This game sucks.
You have no idea.
I just guessed all of that and I was like,
you were wrong about every single thing you said.
I know I was wrong.
You were literally... There is no side missions. There's no bullshit extra missions. There's no hostage situation. Like, as a mission.
Are you sure?
I mean, there's, like, yeah, like, somebody took a hostage and I shot him in the head in the first play, first part. It's not, like, its own mission. No, I don't. I don't understand.
See?
You're wrong. You're not even smart enough to realize you're wrong.
I am not wrong, though. There was a hostage situation, and there was one.
So, you said four other things. You literally said one thing that I did in this playthrough, one thing that you remembered from the first part, and then two things that were just completely wrong.
But they were all right, though.
No, they weren't.
I think you're just lying to me now.
Well, maybe if you actually played the game before shitting on it, you would know.
I don't have to play this game, okay? Yeah, I never.
You don't. You don't have to play it. Yeah, there you go. It's probably good you don't play it because, like,
who's next?
It's not
Mafia 3 is coming out.
Yeah.
It's not up to your standards?
Yeah.
Right, because it doesn't make you want to kill yourself with your body.
Well,
it's actually fun.
the Bloodborne.
It's a little bit relaxing.
Those are relaxing games.
You can look cool. Be a mafia guy.
Have you seen the Bloodborne, like attire?
Yeah, you made me put on some other shit. We started the blind playthrough, by the way. You made me put on some other shit, and I looked like a stupid little, like, fox.
You look dope.
No, I didn't. I looked ugly.
You look super cool.
Look an idiot.
Every outfit in that game is badass.
No, it's not. It's
always badass, too.
Stupid. Literally looked like I had mental illness. I looked like I was, like, one of those, like, I was a special kid. Like, I looked like I needed to hop on the short bus and just take a few trips around the block. That's
Can
what I
someone like. Defend me?
No.
In this situation? Because, like, he's wrong. Like, he's so wrong. He's wrong in every aspect of the word wrong. Like, he's just wrong. His face is wrong. His shirt is wrong. His ideas are wrong.
That's the first relative I've ever come up with so far.
His Mafia 2 is wrong.
What more makes sense?
Mafia 3 is so wrong.
That's just not even relevant.
They're all wrong. Doesn't
make
wrong.
Any sense. Like, I don't understand.
He's a wrong guy.
How can a game be wrong?
It just is.
What does that mean?
You know what it means.
No. I literally don't understand. Like, probably saw nice 95% job. Of things that ever came out. Let's go. And like, not like, like, just because they make no sense.
It shit. Makes sense.
I ain't gonna be able to open it like this.
Yeah, see, that's the issue. You don't really think about like a
battering ram.
I do.
No.
I know.
And low-key do, though.
We'll use that cart.
Low-key, though.
Like, it's another one of those things that's literally so low-key, like, the devil hasn't even seen it.
He's seen it.
Like, he's digging right now trying to find it. That's what he's doing. Like, Lucifer's down there, like, with a shovel. Like, a backhoe, just, like, trying to find your intelligence. And nobody can find it.
I've got the intelligence to pay the bills.
Like, literally, it's like Blackbeard's treasure down there.
We should find that.
As well as, like, your intelligence.
Man, you fuck.
Down there?
They're both down there. Yeah, you can have the intelligence and I'll take the treasure. It's fine.
I want the treasure.
Son of a bitch.
Dude, that's literally the Kardashian family.
Yeah.
Summed up in one sentence.
Burned.
Dude, I just compared you to the Kardashians.
Thanks, man. So rich, though.
Well, no, you're actually not.
I'm gonna be in 10 years.
Just ate the side of Luca.
No. No.
I'm gonna be rich.
Maybe.
Like a motherfucker.
Yeah. I don't know. That makes sense. Are all motherfuckers rich?
Yeah.
Every single one?
Yo, McCree from Overwatch is the baddest motherfucker.
Is he rich?
Argue with that.
Yeah.
It's not true.
Okay, I'm gonna go.
He's a video game character.
Stink like an outhouse. I gotta
in a game with no
tell
currency.
Lady, you don't gotta worry about
like yo, he actually is rich. Like in the lore, he's rich.
Lore stupid.
Guys, he just said lore. He just said lore stupid.
No, the lore for Overwatch is stupid.
Expect? Man, that's better.
Look, before we go home, you wanna give me a hand with Sleeping Beauty?
Even defend your favorite cartoon.
That's not such a bad idea.
I mean, it's got some weird lore, but it's still cool to me.
So anyway, leave a comment, let us know what you think, like the goddamn video, and don't be an ass, bitch.
And John smells like cheese!